A new win for Algerian protesters. The head of the country's constitutional council, Tayeb Belaïd, stepped down on Tuesday as protesters continue demanding the departure of leaders in the old regime. He served as a minister under Abdelaziz Bouteflika for 16 years and later appointed head of the constitutional council for the second time on February the 2nd. His resignation is symbolic because the constitutional council is tasked with vetting election candidates as well as ensuring the regularity of the polls. The Algerian protest movement seems determined in ensuring that all Bouteflika allies are removed from office. It's now a matter of time to see if the remaining old guards will also step down.
Et pour en parler justement,
and to talk about it, Linette, our correspondent Tariq Hafid now joins us from Algiers. Hello, Tariq.
Bonjour.
The president of the Constitutional Council resigned yesterday. Can one say it is a new victory for the citizen movement, which demanded Tayeb Belaïd's departure?
C'est effectivement un nouveau succès à mettre sur le compte du peuple algérien. Depuis le départ de Bouteflika, le mouvement citoyen a maintenu la pression le vendredi et même durant les jours de la semaine pour exiger le départ des trois autres B. Donc Belaïd Tayeb, qui est parti hier.
This is indeed a new win for the Algerian people. On Fridays and even during weekdays, since Bouteflika's departure, the citizen movement kept up with the pressure to demand the departure of other three Bs, Belaïd Tayeb, the prime minister and the leader of the interim government. Yesterday was Belaïd's B that fell. Late Tuesday morning, the official agency APS announced the news. It is an important victory because this 70-year-old was a key figure in the system imposed by the Bouteflika clan. This former magistrate was Minister of Justice for a long time and then chaired the Constitutional Council for the first time before retiring, just to be appointed immediately after the Minister of the Interior. After a term as advisor to the President of the Republic, he was constitutionally appointed to the board on February 10, 2009 by Abdelaziz Bouteflika. And as provided for in the internal regulations of this High Court, he was replaced by one of its members, Magistrate Kamel.
And yesterday, General Ahmed Gaid Salah gave a speech broadcast on state media. The Army Chief of Staff seemed to be particularly threatening General Tufik, the former head of the Secret Service.
We can say that retired General Mohamed Medine said Tufik took him for his rank yesterday. General Ahmed Gaid Salah, who was speaking from the 4th region in southeastern Algeria, once again accused the former boss of intelligence service, the most powerful DRS, of continuing to hold suspicious meetings in order to conspire around the people's demands and hinder the solutions of the National People's Army, as well as the proposals for ending the crisis. This is not the first time that the Chief of Army Staff was pointed a finger at his former colleague, but this time around he did so blatantly. In his speech, General Gaid reassured the population, stating that they have given clear and unequivocal instructions for the protection of citizens, particularly during marches. Politically, this public release of the Chief of Staff is interesting because it suggests that perspectives remain open in order to overcome difficulties and find a solution to the crisis as soon as possible. In other words, the army wants to manage the crisis within a constitutional framework, but it could support a political solution. The pressure of the citizen movement is not weakening. This Tuesday was marked by major student marches across the country. What was the police reaction? Did they use violent means? On Tuesday, university cities experienced a real flood of students. In Algiers, thousands of students manifested in the main arteries of the city center. A police officer was installed early in the morning, but the police officers ended up leaving the premises under the pressure from students, too much in front of the security cordon. So unlike previous days, the police did not use tear gas and there were no arrests. This police reaction contrasts with events that occurred on Friday, the weekly demonstration which ended in scenes of violence. It seems that the General Directorate of National Security has decided to review its strategy and return to more peaceful methods. In any case, Algerians are meeting on Friday for a new national protest during which the departure of the two other bees will be required.
En attendant cela, merci Tariq Afid pour toutes ces informations.
Thank you, Tariq Afid, for all the information.
Merci, au revoir.